once upon a future time in a place called Stardust Bay. Counting down to adventure now. Rockets on a mission, we're on our way. Space racers, surfing the solar winds. Space racers, together the fun begins. Way out where the planets, moons, and stars all shimmer, shine, shine. Having a great time exploring space racers.
Hey, wait for me!
Behold my newest creation, Dodo! Vulture World!
Amazing, boss! Wowie! Incredible! Terrific! What is it?
A theme park designed by me, built by me, dedicated to me.
It looks really, really small. Is it just for little junior cadets?
Dodo, you Dodo! This is just a scale model. The real one will be on the dwarf planet Pluto. No one cares about Pluto. It's been demoted. It's not even a planet anymore. But I am going to bring it back. I shall warm it up, make it look wonderful. And when I'm done, millions of rockets will flock there every year to visit my magnificent theme park.
Theme park? I love theme parks! Will it have rides?
No. Of course it will have rides and fuel stands. 1,000 flavors of fuel. Vulture World TV shows. Vulture World souvenirs.
Soft, snuggly, stuffed Mr. Vultures?
Yes. Soft, snuggly, stuffed Mr. What am I saying? Since the teachers are away on retreat, I thought I'd give the cadets something to do.
Whoa. Check it out!
I have a mission for you. Only the strongest and fastest need apply.
Strongest? That would be me.
Fastest? That would be me.
Ahem. I think he meant me.
No, he meant me.
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 Me!
Actually, this is about me. We are going to terraform Pluto to prepare it for my new theme park, Vulture World!
Whoa, a theme park?
Cool!
What does terraform mean?
Terraforming. To transform another planet in order to make it more like Earth, using things like heat, water, oxygen, and dirt.
I've read all about that. Taking Pluto, which is just a ball of ice, and turning it into a mini Earth. That would be so awesome!
We've never terraformed anything before. You gotta be careful when you mess around with another planet.
Which is why I expect you to be careful. Careful to make Pluto the perfect location for Vulture World. So, do I have any volunteers?
Well, if you guys are going, I'd better come along to keep you out of trouble.
Wish I could go too. But before the teachers went away, they put me in charge of monitoring communications.
Too bad, Crow. We'll miss you.
Well, don't forget to keep me posted. I want to hear all about everything you do.
You got it. Booster rockets.
Engage!
Wings.
Fire!
Space visors.
Down!
Blast off! This is going to be great. I love roller coasters.
I can't believe you guys. This is Vulture building it, remember?
Oh, come on, Robyn. Even Vulture can have a good idea sometimes.
Yeah, I can't wait to play Whack an Asteroid.
And I want to taste every one of those 1,000 flavors of fuel!
Okay. I gotta admit, I really like theme park rides, too. Maybe it'll be a good idea after all.
Okay, time to terraform. So, what do we do first?
We need to smooth out the planet's surface around here. Then we can start adding oxygen and dirt so we can pave over to create the theme park site.
Okay. Oh boy, it's chilly out here.
That's because we're really far from the sun.
Robyn is correct. Pluto is approximately 3.67 billion miles from the sun.
Whoa, no wonder it's so cold. Too cold for a theme park. Let's deploy our artificial suns. They'll generate heat and light just like the real sun. That'll help.
Yeah, and let's release the oxygen too. Without an atmosphere, the heat won't stay on Pluto.
That's much better.
Okay, now it's time to start spreading some dirt.
Wait!
Huh?
Why? What you looking at, Robyn?
The spectrometer says...
H2O, two hydrogen atoms and one oxygen atom.
But H2O is water.
Water? That puddle wasn't there before.
There weren't three new suns in the sky before either. They've started melting Pluto's ice.
But the ice on Pluto isn't water ice. Isn't it made of other stuff? Frozen nitrogen, methane, carbon monoxide?
Eagle, the spectrometer analyzes all sorts of objects and tells us exactly what they're made of. Remember?
H2O, two hydrogen atoms and one oxygen atom.
Water.
You know what this means, right? Rule number one.
The most important rule of space exploration? First, do no harm.
Huh. If there's any chance of life developing on a planet, we have to leave it alone.
But Pluto isn't a planet. Not anymore. It was too small, so it was demoted, remember? Now it's just a dwarf planet.
I don't think that matters. We're talking about water, which means we're talking about potential new life. And that means wings off.
Hold it. Yeah, we found a little water, but maybe it's the only water on all of Pluto. In fact, maybe one of us accidentally brought it from Earth.
Well, I did wash up a few weeks ago.
You see? Maybe Hawk brought it. I mean, what would water be doing all the way out here?
Ava, could Pluto have water?
Affirmative. Previous observations confirm that there may be water ice on Pluto. It must have melted when you set up the artificial suns.
So now what?
We leave.
I think we should ask Headmaster Crane what to do. After all, we only found a little puddle.
Pluto to Earth. Pluto to Earth. Come in, Stardust Bay.
Earth to Pluto. Hey, guys, how you doing?
Not so well.
We found water.
Just a teensy-weensy bit of water.
Are you sure? Because if there's water...
There's water. We've confirmed it.
Uh-oh. Rule number one, huh?
That's right.
It's just a little puddle, so we wanted to talk to Headmaster Crane about it.
Gee, he and the other teachers aren't back from the retreat yet. I think you better come back and wait for them to...
Talk to whom? Who is that?
It's Pluto, sir, but...
Hello, out there on Pluto! How's everything going?
Sir, I just advised them to come home and talk to Headmaster Crane.
No need, they can talk to me. I'm the chairman of the school board. So, how are things coming along?
Do you know rule number one?
Of course. So?
It turns out there's water on Pluto, which means there's a possibility of life. Which means we can't continue to terraform.
What? You're going to squash my beautiful theme park because of a little water?
You know the rule, Mr. Vulture.
I've already had a loco designed. Engineers are working on all the rides. And now a little water is going to make my dream impossible?
Maybe you can build the theme park somewhere else.
There is nowhere else. I've applied for building permits everywhere else, and I was turned down. This was my last chance in the solar system to build Vulture World.
It's okay, boss. We'll think of something.
It's all right. It'll be okay.
Too bad about the theme park.
Yeah, we'll leave our supplies here just in case we come back sometime. Over and out.
Don't feel bad, boss. You know, this reminds me of our first trip to Mars when we were in kindergarten. Remember? There was evidence of water, and you were so careful because you wanted life to develop on Mars so you could build a special playground just for little Martians.
I was only a child.
But Headmaster Emu was so proud of you for not messing around on Mars. He gave you a gold star.
My only gold star. You know, Headmaster Emu said something else that I've never forgotten.
What? Like stop being mean to all the other kids?
Not that! He also said, if you have a dream, Rapacious, don't give up. And I am not giving up on this dream. Some rules are meant to be broken. Come, Dodo, we have some terraforming to do. Dodo, turn those suns back on. And be careful with that model.
Aye, aye, boss.
My beautiful Vulture World, I can see you now. Oh, Dodo.
Yes, boss?
We're supposed to be terraforming Pluto. Not me!
Right. I'll just dust you off. Oh, what's this?
What's what?
Well, boss, you kind of sprouted.
What in blazing blue comets are you talking about?
Right up there on your head.
What is that? A flower? Get it off me!
Warning, the flower is a life form. According to rule number one, if there's any chance of life developing on a planet, you must leave it alone.
What are you talking about? It's growing on me!
This does not matter. The flower is growing on you, and you are both on Pluto. We are not permitted to harm it, so you must allow it to grow.
Ah!
So I'm afraid you cadets will have to do without your theme park.
That's okay. We understand.
I'm not sure Vulture does, though.
I still think you look beautiful, boss.